mankind. It's your old buddy, the sun. Except on those real hot days when I make your head ache and unsettle your stomach. But when I come on a little too strong, have an Alka-Seltzer on the rocks. That'll settle your stomach and soothe your aching head. Next time I get to be too much, have an Alka-Seltzer on the rocks and you'll be all set.
You wouldn't think of setting sail without life jackets or starting the day without breakfast. But since you know they don't always eat right, make sure they get all the vitamins people normally need to take. Make one-a-day vitamins part of every vacation. One-a-day vitamins, every day, even if you spend it at home.
The Huntley-Brinkley Report continues, brought to you by Benjamin Moore Paints and your nearby Benjamin Moore paint dealer. The man to see for all your painting needs.
Painter gets some funny calls these days. Like this man, in a hurry because he's moving. Use the best, he says. And that's Benjamin Moore's Moore Guard. Great for do-it-yourselfers, too. Okay, okay. Even Moore Guard takes a little time. He may have to finish his job himself. He's still in luck, though, because Moore Guard's available everywhere. Same great quality all across the country.
See your nearby Benjamin Moore dealer for all your painting needs.
Dr. Edward F. Berman is Edgar F. Berman is physician to Hubert Humphrey. Perhaps because of this, he wound up on two Democratic Party political committees looking for ways to win elections. Well, members of committees like this tend to talk a lot. Dr. Berman, in a burst of zeal, said he would oppose a woman president because, he said, there is a time in a woman's life when, because of glandular changes, she becomes somewhat emotional, unstable, and said he would not want a president making critical decisions while having what he called curious mental aberrations. Cooler heads on the committee suggested he quit immediately. The women members were furious. Today, Dr. Berman held a news conference.
Berman announced he is resigning from the Democratic Committee on National Priorities. He said he is quitting so his views will not embarrass the party or Humphrey, whom he called his best friend. Berman said some of his critics are seeking political advantage with women voters. He seemed astounded that his medical opinion caused such a political furor.
As a physician, I reiterate my scientific position that women are different physically, physiologically, and psychologically, regardless of politics, medical or otherwise. The difference, I think, is a credit to both sexes. If people do not know that there is such a condition as premenstrual tension, if doctors do not know, they'd better go back to school. If people do not know there is an abnormal psychological condition known as menopause, then they'd better go back to medical school. They certainly know there's pregnancy. I've never said women are inferior to men. I've said they are different, and vive la différence.
The other day, Senator Scott, the Republican leader, said the Democratic Congress was spending July money to win November votes. And another Republican said the Democrats were spending money like drunken sailors. The Democratic leader, Mike Mansfield, says today that in some cases they have voted to spend more money than the president wanted, but in other cases they had voted less. And when they were through, he said, the president's budget would be cut, not expanded. These political arguments are familiar. But over the years, it has turned out more often than not that Congress has voted to spend every dime the government had, plus a few more it did not. Chet?
2 weeks ago, two Chicago policemen were shot to death by snipers at a housing project. Four suspects were arrested. Mayor Daley said he would spend $3 million on security and services at the project, Cabrini Homes, but black leaders say it's typical of all that's bad about low-income public housing.
These are the children of the Cabrini Project. Most are fatherless, most are poor, and most of them have little hope for the future. This is Ensign Anthony Watson, who was born and raised in this project. He went away to the Annapolis Naval Academy, was class president twice, and brigade commander. He's back in Chicago now on a temporary assignment, and he decided to live in Cabrini again. Watson says things have changed since he lived here as a boy, mostly for the worse.
It wasn't quite as complicated. It didn't seem to me as if it was a jungle, as it does now. Now it's almost like walking through a patch in Vietnam, worrying about whether snipers or you're coming down on you or not. You just don't know. Back in those days, way back when I was a little kid, we didn't have that type of pressure. We didn't have to worry about it. We didn't have any real large gang elements involved. And today, we not only have gang elements, but we've got gang elements that are opposing each other. And consequently, people who aren't involved with either side get caught in the middle. It is like a jungle. You don't have to come in and tell the kids that they're poor. You don't have to come in and tell them that they don't have any food to eat, or they don't have any clothes to wear to school or to church on Sunday. You don't have to come in and tell them that they don't have a home to go to at night. They know that. They know that from the time that they're able to walk and talk. And they see the dope addicts, and they see the gang elements, and they see the prostitutes on the streets and in the buildings. They see all this type of thing, and this is their social atmosphere. This is something that they grow up in. This is something that they can't escape from, the ghetto, a situation from which they are not able to escape. I think one of our best approaches might be to concentrate on trying to give some opportunity to the young people, to give them some sign that there is a ray of hope left in Cabrini. So we have to give these people a taste of success, something that they might feel makes them a part of America, because I don't think they feel they are a part of America.
I'll say it, I have a constipation problem every week.
What have you tried?
Lots of things, but I'm not satisfied.
You need something different. Try Seritan.
What's different about Seritan?
Unlike magnesia oils or pills, Seritan has a regulating ingredient, like in fruits and vegetables. Works more normally to help restore your regularity.
Seritan solved my problem.
If you have a constipation problem every week, take Seritan daily. Get regular. Keep regular. Lainey Kazan.
I get a warm romantic notion when you use aqua velvet lotion. That's how our romance began, because there's something about an aqua velvet man.
Men, put it on. Aqua velvet with your neck. So good for your face and all that manly fragrance. Aqua velvet. Put it on.
The nerve gas the Army plans to haul across the South and dump at sea is so deadly, anyone exposed at close range will die in 2 minutes. Exposure a mile away causes death in 2 hours. But the Army says that won't happen. Several congressmen, however, are worried about this hideous chemical being hauled through several states and put into the sea, and they have asked the Army to hold it up while they investigate. There was very little movement in the stock market today. Not much happened one way or another. The Dow Jones Industrials lost a fraction of a point. An average share on the New York Exchange lost 3 cents, and on the American, an average share gained 2 cents. Chet?
And so, this difficult moment is here. In leaving this post after almost 14 years, I recommend to you the NBC Nightly News, which begins tomorrow. It'll be in the most capable hands of David, John Chancellor, and Frank McGee. I'll be watching with interest and affection. I might also remind you that American journalism, all of it, is the best anywhere in the world. I want to thank the entire staff of NBC, for this nightly broadcast has not been an individual effort by any means. And as for you out there, I thank you first for your patience, then for your many kindnesses and the flattering things you have said and written. More difficult to take, to be sure, has been your criticism, but that too has been helpful and in most cases valid. But you have bolstered my conviction that this land contains an incredible quality and quantity of good common sense, and it's in no danger of being led down the primrose path by a journalist. At the risk of sounding presumptuous, I would say to all of you, be patient and have courage, for there will be better and happier news one day. if we work at it. And David, thanks for these years of happy association and for being such an easy colleague to work with and for all the kindnesses.
Chet, I too would like to thank all of those who tune us in and put up with us, particularly including those who write the nasty letters. McGee and Chancellor and I will be here every night. We'll miss you. Last night, NBC had a dinner for Chet and gave all of us a chance to say goodbye to him. And as a farewell gift, NBC gave him a horse. So, Chet, when you ride away to the west, to Montana, on your new horse, I will have to admit to at least a mild envy. And when you're out there under clear skies and clean air, maybe once in a while you will think of those of us still here, fighting the traffic, the transportation breakdowns, strikes, pollution, and wondering what is left that we can eat, drink, smoke, or breathe that will not kill us, and wondering what horror will be visited upon us next. In these years, I have often been stopped in public by people, always polite, who knew I was either Huntley or Brinkley, but weren't sure which. And so they would ask, well, from now on, when somebody stops me in the street and says, aren't you Chet Huntley? I have an answer. It is no, ma'am. He is the one out west on a horse. I really don't want to say it, but the time has come. And so, for the last time, good luck and good night, Chet.
Good luck, David. And good night for NBC News.
How can you be such a stickler for safety and do nothing about glare? Maybe you wear sunglasses. But conventional sunglasses darken glare, and that's not the same as getting rid of it. What you need are the Safe Driver sunglasses. Cool-ray Polaroid sunglasses with the optical barrier that wipes out reflected glare and lets you see. Cool-ray Polaroid sunglasses. See about them.
On a day like this, what does a guy like you who wears glasses, what do you do about glare? Ordinary sunglasses only darken it. But Cool-Ray Polaroid flip-ups have the famous Polaroid lens with the optical barrier that wipes out reflected glare. So you get a much better look at this beautiful world. Get Cool-Ray Polaroid flip-up sunglasses only where you see this tag.
WSM Television reminds you of your responsibility 19... 19-